in this country. And if you look at that chart, the rules for unvaccinated people are much more limiting. You mostly have to be masked, even if outdoors, according to the CDC chart. But you just said, you know, it's minusculely low. According to the CDC, less than 10% of cases of COVID-19 have been occurring outdoors. Couldn't these recommendations have gone farther even?
You know, Savannah, there'll always be that argument that the CDC, being a science-based organization, always wants to wait until the evidence they get is clear. Even though you know that it's still low, there's always that argument that the CDC tends to be a bit conservative. But they do that because they want to make sure they get it completely right and err always on the side of safety. But what I'll guarantee you're going to see, Savannah, as more and more people get vaccinated, which will absolutely result in less and less people getting infected. And the numbers per day, the weekly average of a daily number of cases is going to go down. And when it does, you are definitely going to see the CDC come back and be more flexible. What? Right now, they're going slowly about it. They're being very prudent about it. But as the case numbers come down, they're going to be pulling back on some of the restrictions, guaranteed.
I get it. You know, it sets up a strange situation, especially when you start talking about kids. I'll tell you a story. I walked to pick up my little girl at the bus stop yesterday after the CDC recommendations came out. I took off my mask. I waited for her. There was no one else around. She got off the bus with her little mask on. She had to wear her mask. I didn't on the walk home. When are kids going to be able to take off those masks and play outside at the playground?
You know, that's going to be the same thing that I mentioned a moment ago. It's going to be a situation, well, first of all, kids will ultimately wind up getting vaccinated, but you want to have some activity in that direction before they do. High school kids will likely get vaccinated as we get into the fall term, and children of any age will likely be vaccinated by the time we get to the end of the year. But let's not talk about the end of the year. Let's talk about the immediate or intermediate future. When children are out in the community, when you have 30, 40, 50,000 new infections per day, they are unvaccinated now because children can't get vaccinated now. And for that reason, they are more at risk of getting infected because they are out in the community where there is a lot of infection. When the community level starts to go way down, the risks to everybody, including the children, is going to be dramatically diminished.
But isn't it a weird situation because I'm not fully vaccinated yet? I can take off my mask and walk home. She can't. Like, doesn't that just point up that the CDC guidelines, there's some kind of disconnect if that's the situation?
Well, yeah. What you're pointing out, what you're referring to, Savannah, is the top two not fully vaccinated, that people can go out without masks. If you walk, run with members of your household, attend a small outdoor gathering, fully vaccinated with friends. Then after that, everything has a mask on it, as you're showing correctly now on the screen. So what you're asking, if you are on the left-hand part and you see unvaccinated people, walk outdoors with members of your household. And you're asking now, if your child is a member of your household, can you walk outdoors with your child without a mask? According to that chart, the answer is yes.
But the child can't, not to beat it to death.
Yes.
Okay.